No book, no rule helps you to learn communication. Please remember, communication comes only with practice. How much practice? Endless practice. You go on practicing till you become perfect. So when we say LSRW, you need to improve all the four skills within these 2 days. Is that okay? So within 2 days, what are we going to practice? We are going to practice listening, speaking. We means you. We doesn't mean I. Okay, I'm doing speaking. Now I will do listening when you speak. Did you understand? I will read for you, then I'll make you read. And then I will write. You know, I won't write, but I will make you write. Are you ready? Are you willing? You know, if you're unwilling, I don't feel like telling you. Then I can go on speaking for 2 days. My English will become very good. Your English will become very bad. Because you're not getting any practice. I'm getting all the practice. You understand? So what is important for you is each individual should do practice. Not only, you know, 4 or 5 students do the practice. I want all 54 here, plus whoever is attending from Impact. Everybody has to practice everything. No sitting quietly and saying, "Madam, I'm not well, my throat is aching." My throat is aching, you know, I'm not supposed to speak. For 2 months the doctors told me don't speak. And I came because I promised Gampa sir, I came and I'm speaking to all of you. So we cannot make excuses. I cannot whisper to you. Can you hear me? So I have to speak loudly. They've given me a nice mic which is catching my voice beautifully. So you're able to hear. I cannot come here and close my eyes saying I'm very ill. We cannot make any excuses. Because if we make excuses, we are not going to improve. If you want successful life, you must do your education well, but you must learn communication well. Without communication, success is not possible, like your madam told you. With communication, the success, the sky is the limit. How much success can you get? You can get endless success if you have communication. So today we will practice 2 exercises, that is listening and speaking. Tomorrow we will do 2 exercises, that is reading and writing. Today I'm going to let you off a little early. I planned the workshop from 10 to 4, but suddenly one of my colleagues passed away last week. Therefore, I need to go there at 3:30 to Arts College. So exactly at 3 or maybe 2:50, we will close today's session. You can still sit here and do the practice. I won't be there, but nobody stops you from practicing for 1 hour. That shows that you are self-confident. That shows that you are motivated. Don't leave the hall before 4, even if I leave it. I am leaving because of some very important work. Tomorrow we will have 10 to 4. I hope the vehicle will come on time and I will reach here so that we can begin. I hope there will be no introduction, so we won't start a little late. We will start dot of 10. Because see, now I told you about content. What is content I'm talking about here? Importance of time. You know, in our life, money can be got again. But time cannot be got. If you finish 1 minute of your time, that 1 minute cannot be earned back. If you lose 100 rupees, you can earn it again by working hard. That's possible. So, people used to say, time is money. That was a saying in English. But time is not money. Time is more precious than money. It's more precious than gold, diamond, anything. Time is very, very important. So we need to learn that. That is a part of content. So this workshop mainly, I thought that we will talk about both these things. Language and content. But I'm going to concentrate mainly on content, Because if you want more on language, you can look at what I have said already. Impact is very nice, you know, they keep posting it. And people from all over the world, not only India, they see it, they feel very happy. But only worry is they call up. I can't talk to 500 people per day, can I? I can't answer lakhs of calls, can I? So I tell everybody, and this is going to be recorded, I'm sure it is going to be put on impact, so I'm telling again. No phone calls. Email also, if you send me, learn by doing what is called as self-learning, self-improvement. So each one of you, after these 2 days, will take care of your own self-improvement. You want, how much English do you want to learn? How much content you want to learn? How good you want your communication skills to be? These questions you ask yourself today. And then you start improving yourself. That is called self-improvement. And that is what I'm suggesting to each of you, because no amount of teaching can help us. Only what can help us is what we practice. Now I'll show you one picture. Do you have any idea whose picture this is? Yeah, if anybody knows, please answer. Yeah. Yes. You were there in the last workshop also. Very good, I'm so happy. This is a person called Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. There was one impact program in Nalgonda where there were about 2,800 students. I used this book that was blue in color at that time. This is a new cover. And then I got thousands of mails saying where to get the book, how to get the book, what is this book. So I thought this time I will base my entire workshop on this book. This book is called Tales and Parables of Sri Ramakrishna. This is how it looks. If you get a copy of this book, you have to go to near Indira Park. There is a place called Ramakrishna Mutt. You can get the copy. For those who are going to watch this video, any Ramakrishna Mutt center will have a copy all over India, wherever centers are there. If not, Chennai Ashram, Chennai Ramakrishna Mutt, if you order, you'll get. This book is available online also. Now, why am I using this book? Because it gives us a wide variety of awareness. It gives us a wide variety of values and ideas. Many people might feel that, you know, this is a religious text. It isn't. It has nothing to do with religion if you take religion in the negative sense of the term. These days there is much controversy about religion. But religion is not bad. Religion is a practical way of living well. You know, you want to live efficiently? Follow the rules of your religion, follow the values of your religion, you'll be very happy. But this stories, you know, it is called tales and parables. You know what tales mean? What does it mean? Story. Very good. See how our vocabulary improves? We have another word that is parables. Parable is a story with a moral. Usually a story which teaches us some good thing. That is what we call as a parable. So it says tales and parables of Sri Ramakrishna. Now look at here, preposition. Don't we learn prepositions in our grammar? So we have tales and parables, and here conjunction of preposition. So are we not learning grammar? Without looking at a grammar book, just by looking at the title of a book, we are learning grammar. Can you understand? We are also learning vocabulary, because I told you what tales and parables mean. If you know, if you don't know, you can learn. If you already know, you can revise, you know. We always can revise. Whatever is known to us, we can always revise, draw. So this is how the book looks. It can look anything else. The name is there. And now we have to use this book. So what are we going to use it for? We are going to use it first for learning some content. I have identified some stories and I have identified some learning activity also from those stories. For instance, the first story which we are going to talk about is a story which teaches us self-help, self-improvement. I gave you the example of self-improvement. How to improve your English? By practicing on your own. You know, whenever somebody says practice on your own, we say no, no, we would like to have only somebody teaching us. Madam, can you suggest one book from which I can learn communication? You will never learn communication from a book. The book will give you ideas, but you have to practice it yourself. Do you follow? So, self-help, that is our first story.